Thank you. a member of the Timucua board, which is such a fun treat, and we're so happy to have you here tonight. If you are new, we're going to go over a couple of housekeeping items just so you're aware of how we do things here at Timucua. One is hopefully you brought in a glass or some food with you. We hope that you'll enjoy the wine and the treats throughout the evening. You want to keep those things with you, and when you exit tonight, you'll want to bring those things out into our lobby area and hand them to a volunteer. Good?
Yeah.
Hang on. And if you're on one of the higher levels, we highly suggest not leaning forward with your glasses or your plates. Just as a precaution.
Safety tip.
We could do a hashtag safety tip. So also, if you need to use the restroom this evening, we have our restrooms on each floor. There's one here in the back, one there in the back, and one there in the back, so you can locate those. In case of emergency this evening, we will want you to not trample one another, but walk very slowly and kindly out the doors where you came, or you can also look for the emergency exit signs. And last but not least, if you have brought your cell phone with you, as I have on stage, please go ahead and silence it, but we do encourage you to take photos tonight without the use of your flash and post those on social media. We'd love for you to share about your experience here at Timucua. You can even use the hashtag TimucuaArts. So Benoit and Alain have been wonderful in hosting us for 10 years here in their living room. We hope that you enjoy this evening, and I'm going to invite Benoit up to share a little bit more.
Thank you so much, Jessica. We have a wonderful board, a few members of which are here. All right, so just an additional note about the bathroom. The downstairs toilet has been acting up. I plunged it twice today. So, you know, it's working now, but I hate these toilets. If you want to be sure not to have any problems, I would recommend using the upper two floors just in case. But, you know, again, we have volunteers, and mostly me, I'm the plumber around here. So, anyways, as soon as we raise enough money, we're going to change these toilets for ones that actually work. These are just not good. All right, so, but that's done with that. We have a wonderful artist tonight, Jim Preston. How about that? We've got two pieces to work on. He's going to do some different stuff, which is cool to see always. Of course, you see Boris with another piece here. And he's got other work in the, including some prints, if I see correctly.
No, there's no pictures of paintings he's done before.
All right. Okay, good. And but these originals are for sale, and we're talking about like $500 for the big ones. He says, I'm going to say $300 for the little ones. Very affordable. Anyways, talk to him if you want to buy one, which I'm seeing, like even through the light, I could see people are excited. Don't trample one another after the game. Just go talk to Jim and buy his painting. We hope you will. And if you buy this one here, he will donate the proceeds to the foundation, which is very generous of him. Please give him a nice round of applause. I hope that shows well in the light too, right? It shows well. If I show it to you, it won't show well in the light. All right. So we hope that you know we have memberships, and we hope that you will become a member if you're not already a member. If you are, I hope you'll think of renewing your membership, because of course, you know, we need the support of the community to keep going, and I hope you think that it's important that we do keep going. And so that's a very important thing for us, a very important source of revenue, is your membership. And with your membership, you get half off ticketed events, which are few and far between, but some big ones are coming up, and you're gonna save your membership in no time, just in the rebates. And you also get seated first at events, at all events, and 10% off selected businesses in the area, and then we're working on more perks. There's a members only section of the website. You get a special newsletter. We have some special events, members only, coming up soon. We're trying to make sure that you enjoy your membership and you feel a part of the family. And we have a very important concert coming up, which you saw the ad for earlier, with a very intriguing looking character in the picture who we will not point with our elbows. So anyhow, it's the Son of a Chamber concert. And some John Adams and some very, very seminal and important and difficult work, and I hope that you're going to come for that, which is not here, October 26th at Factor. So Factor, did I say that correctly? I'm close. So it's not that far from here, right? It's like Ivanhoe, yeah, Virginia Drive, like it's, yeah, it's not far. So I hope you're going to buy your tickets and come to that. How much are the tickets?
$20,
10 for members, there you go. That and one more event I know of, which I can't tell you about, and you saved 60% of your membership right there in two events. I'm just saying. All right, so I'm done. But I do have to introduce our group tonight, which is the Alterity Wind Quintet. So please.
Chamber Orchestra, which this is a subgroup of. This is our sixth chamber concert of the year so far. We started in April, and the October 26th concert is going to be our first full concert with the full Chamber Orchestra, which is really exciting, and hope you'll be there.
It's going to be a really great program, and we just want to say thank you so much, everyone, for being here tonight, and we hope to see you on the 26th.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and thank you CF2 for writing all this wonderful music.
Yeah.
And I believe
I know you all came here tonight to hear 4 to 7 people talk for 30 minutes before coming to a concert, so I'll disappoint you by being brief. The first piece on tonight's program is a piece that I wrote. My name is David McDonald, by the way. Hi, everyone. I will tell you a little bit more about myself and CF2 a little bit later in the program, but first I want to tell you about this piece that you're about to hear. It's called Stumpery, which does not sound like a very appetizing thing, I'm aware, but it is a real word. I didn't invent it. Stumpery is a type of garden. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri, and my parents like to go for a walk in this wonderful series of gardens in St. Louis called the Missouri Botanical Garden. If any of you ever visit St. Louis, I highly recommend it. They just opened a new garden there this year called a stumpery, which was not a thing that I was familiar with, and I had to do at least 3 Google searches before I figured out what it was. And it's a little bit like a rock garden, where rocks are the primary feature. Interesting rocks are the primary feature of a garden, but instead of rocks, it's kind of upturned tree stumps, where you see all these like really intricate vine-like things that used to be hidden under the ground are now on display, and you see these things that used to be these very lifelike fluid things are now kind of frozen in place. And so you'll hear a lot of things in this piece that behave a little bit like that. There are these vine-like tendrils of counterpoint that move around and are frozen in space, and you hear the reverberations that were maybe left behind after the tree was uprooted. And so I want to thank Alterity for their wonderful work preparing this work, and please enjoy Stumpery.
Thank you.
It's called The Timeless. Some music. I don't need to say anything. It's music, you know. Hey, you, what's going on? But this piece, I think you really need some explanation. So I printed out my program notes. It's short one, so I will just read it for you. Time-lapse intersection. This piece reflects overlapping moments between pose and motion from all different directions of our lives. From here to there, a big range of emotions may be revealed. Delight and sadness, hope and frustration, rage and forgiveness. There are countless good and bad decisions in my memories, in nature, and in the world in which we live. I only hope to be more observant to see different directions and worlds so that I could have better understanding of others' perspectives. In this world, we see many contrary things exist like those emotions. Regardless of directions and place you go, this path can be traced back to one place. It is numerous directions and intersections which blend together as the harmony of human history. The opening four notes, which is C sharp, D, B flat, A, and you will hear di-ra-di-ra, these four notes. These are the main motivic idea of my piece. This motif shifts in each section but remains a center tone as a grounding element throughout the piece. The shifts in motivic expression represent the numerous routes which people may be taking that lead toward a common destination. The destination is not always clear, but I am very curious to know. I hope you enjoy the piece. Time lapse in the session. Thank you.
Thank you. First time here, and I will be a member. Thank you. Thank you.
As I said earlier, my name is David McDonald. In addition to having written the first piece in the program, and I promise it's not just because this is the case, but I'm also the president of the Central Florida Composers Forum. I want to really thank everyone for coming out tonight to hear not just a wonderful performance by a wonderful ensemble, but a performance that includes so much brand new music, including my piece. And I don't want to speak for everybody, but I think for all but one or two of these, this is the first time these have ever been performed. And that, to me, is really exciting, that we get to hear music that was, yeah. Thank you. This is a good thing. So you all heard some music tonight that has never been heard by human ears in any performance ever on the history of the planet, which is really cool, and What's even cooler is that it was written by people who live right here in your community, people who live in the Central Florida area, and performed by people who live right here in the Central Florida community, people just like you. And so I wanted to just tell you a little bit about our organization, Central Florida Composers Forum. We're a group of composers from all over Orlando, as far away as, well, I think, Chanchi, where do you come in from?
Coco?
So pretty far away. So we got Coco, and Jim came in from Mount Dora. So we go a little outside of Orlando, too. And we get together and talk about our music, and several times a year we present performances of our music to the people in our community. It's a lot of fun, and I wanted to invite anybody who's interested in any of this to come check us out. There are people in the group who are interested in all different kinds of musical expression. Some of us are very into concert music as our primary focus. Some of us are focused more on media, music for film, television, video games, and a lot of us are interested in all sorts of things, both of those things and a lot more. There are people of all different levels of training and different educational backgrounds, and it's really fun for us to all get together. You all heard Jim's piece just a moment ago, and while Jim and I have been corresponding on and off over the last few months, this is actually the first time we've met. It was earlier this morning at our last rehearsal. And one of the things Jim commented to me was that he's been part of Composers Forums before, but found that ours was uniquely welcoming and supportive. I want to make sure, yes. So I point that out just to say again that if anybody here thinks this is something you would be interested in doing, you are welcome to come to a meeting or anything like that. You can find out more about us, cfcomposers.org, that's C as in Central, F as in Florida, composers.org. And you can find out about when we have things going on, and of course you can get in touch with me directly. You can find my contact information there, or you can just catch me after the concert tonight. And before I go, I want to just reiterate again that these guys are incredible, and that you should all go hear their concert next Thursday, the 26th at Factor. It's going to be a really, really cool show, and you'll see me there too. So thank you all so much for performing our music tonight.
Thank you.
Yeah. Actually, Sharon, do you want to come up and say a bit about your piece up in the back?
Epilogue. So I kind of think that the piece speaks for itself, but I'll say a few words. Since politics in our country has become a very sensitive topic, I'll try not to be too political in my introductions, because I think the title says it all. But before the election in 2016, I watched the news very, very intently. I followed the election ad nauseum. I was very concerned about our country, like many, I'm sure many of you are, about the divisiveness in our government and in our country. And after many months of tensely watching the debates and the news, the election was finally over. And personally, I was not too happy with the outcome, and I seriously needed to vent. So this is what you're going to get. But thank God for music, right? Because this is not get it out. So here is my piece, post-election epilogue. And my intent in this piece, it's dissonant. It can be very disturbing. The beginning part is intended to be like a death march. You'll find many voices interfering with one another, because that's kind of how I see the government. Nobody really listening to each other. So I hope you enjoy it. And thank you.
Thank you.
I have a special request. I don't know if you hear that high pitch sound sometimes.
Yes.
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 I think maybe somebody's hearing aid is feeding back.
Yes.
And so could you please check if you have hearing aids, because I'm very careful about keeping the house quiet. I'm pretty sure it's none of my stuff. So I mean, it's not impossible. Maybe a light started to be noisy. It happens, you know, but they're, you know, I check them regularly. So check your hearing aids if you have them. Then maybe someone is feeding back. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name's Keith, and this is our last piece, and I want to let you know a million things, and I was talking long, so I'll try to keep short, how much these passionate musicians have put intense time into these pieces. And, you know, as a composer, especially when we are asked to, you know, we get the opportunity to write pieces, you want to try things that are new. And a lot of times those things that are new they're difficult. And they take a great deal of rehearsal time. And sometimes, you know, you don't, it's one thing to have rehearsal, not enough rehearsal time. It's another thing to have musicians who are just maybe not as interested, but that latter is simply not the case for these folks. They spent extra time working on it. This piece is four movements. They're all very short. And the first one is Nostalgia. And I was kind of hoping, what it focuses on is these alternate fingerings. Could you maybe show an alternate feeling? So it's like the wrong way to play the right note, right? It's got a different color, and so I wanted to experiment with these different changes of microtonal changes and color changes. That's what the first one's about. The second one is called Alone, and I put really, really high pitches and things in the oboe, which I should never have done. So it features the oboe. And then the third piece features French horn, and it's called Great River, and you'll see why. And then the last one was another big stretch, and luckily these great folks have stepped up to it, especially Carrie. I asked early on, I said, Carrie, how about some hip-hop beatboxing? And wait till you hear what she did with it. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Is going to happen February 4th. There was so much music that I pulled my piece out. My piece is almost an hour long. Oh. So I pulled my piece out, and we're going to do a special concert just for that. It's 16 movements with poetry involved and some projections. It's really cool. So, but we're here to talk about...
October 26th is the debut of the full 16-piece ensemble, Alternative Chamber Orchestra. If you like what you heard tonight, if you support this group, put some money in the bowl. Put some more money in the bowl. If you put $20 in the bowl, you can take home a ticket to the October 26th concert tonight. And we would love to pack that 200-seat venue. So buy a ticket tonight and support this group that did an amazing job.
Folk double bill from North Carolina and from the Tampa, St. Petersburg area, two groups. So check it out and talk to Jim. You want to buy his artwork, right?
Yeah! Yeah.